In the name of Christ, we welcome you.
We have been called out of darkness into God's marvelous light.
Grace and peace be with you.
And also with you.
Good morning. You're very welcome to this celebration of Holy Communion, which includes a healing service.
The love of God has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. We dwell in him, and he dwells in us. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the peoples. Sing to God. Sing praises to his name.
And speak of all his marvelous works.
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty.
Who was and is to come.
Heavenly Father, you anointed your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and with power to bring us the blessings of your kingdom. Anoint your church with the same Holy Spirit, that we who share in his suffering and victory may bear witness to the gospel of salvation through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Reading from St. Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 5, beginning at verse 1. Therefore, since we are justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have obtained access to this grace in which we stand. And we boast in our hope of sharing the glory of God, and not only that, but we also boast in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not disappoint us, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. Indeed, rarely will anyone die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a person someone might actually dare to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Psalm 116. I love the Lord, for he has heard the voice of my supplication, because he inclined his ear to me on the day I called to him. How shall I repay the Lord for all the benefits he has given to me? I will lift up the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. Precious is the sight of the Lord, is the death of his faithful servants. O Lord, I am your servant, the child of your handmaid. You have freed me from my bonds. I will offer to you a sacrifice of thanksgiving and call upon the name of the Lord. I will fulfill my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people. In the courts of the house of the Lord, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem. Hear the gospel of our Savior Christ according to St. Matthew, chapter 9, beginning at verse 35.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Then Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues, and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom, and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them, because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest." Then Jesus summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits, to cast them out and to cure every disease and every sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, also known as Peter, and his brother Andrew. James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. Philip and Bartholomew. Thomas and Matthew the tax collector. James, son of Alphaeus, and Thaddeus, Simon the Cananean, and Judas Iscariot, the one who betrayed him. These 12 Jesus sent out with the following instructions. Go nowhere among the Gentiles, and enter no town of the Samaritans, but go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. As you go, proclaim the good news. The kingdom of heaven has come near. Cure the sick, raise the dead, cleanse the lepers, cast out demons. You received without payment. Give without payment. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of my lips and the meditations of all of our hearts be forever acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Amen. In recent months, I've heard some comparisons between what we've been experiencing with the coronavirus lockdown and the experience of people who lived during the Second World War, and in particular, during the Belfast Blitz. The fundamental difference, of course, is that the enemy in the 1940s could be seen and heard. So when the German bombers flew over Belfast, the air raid sirens would be sounded, and people knew that they had to take shelter. Unfortunately, that didn't always mean that they survived, but at least they had some forewarning that danger was imminent. The coronavirus pandemic, however, is not like that. Unless somebody around you shows obvious signs of having the virus, it's very difficult to know whether or not you are in danger of getting it yourself. It's possible, therefore, that you've already had it but haven't developed any symptoms. It's also possible that you haven't had it yet, but if and when you do, you might end up seriously, perhaps even fatally, ill in hospital. Most of us simply do not know. And because of this uncertainty, this inability to say for definite where the virus is active and spreading, we have had to endure the lockdown regulations in an attempt to stop the spread of the virus. And for the majority of people who have taken the lockdown seriously, we have had to make some real sacrifices, and in some cases endure economic hardship or strains on our mental health, as we do our bit to prevent the virus from getting into us or from getting into other people through us. And although we are very slowly beginning to see light at the end of the tunnel, there is no doubting that this microscopic enemy has brought society as we know it to its knees. And in response, as a nation, we have invested so much money and effort into ending the stranglehold that this
invisible virus has upon us. We do so because we recognize the devastating biological effects that this microscopic little thing can have on our physical bodies. As Christians, though, our concern in general should not just be upon our physical health. For despite the fact that we are flesh and blood, there is also a spiritual dimension to our being. You can call it your soul or your spirit, but whatever you call it, it is that part of us that will continue to exist when our human body dies. And what's very important for us to understand that in the exact same way that our physical bodies can be infected by things like the coronavirus, so too can our spirit be infected. Now, I'm not talking about the extremes, something like demonic possession. I'm talking much more generally about the common or garden damage that is inflicted upon us spiritually simply by living in this broken and corrupt world. Take this for example. If a stranger came up to you in the street and punched you in the face for absolutely no reason, then you would probably have bruising for a few days after. But you'd also likely have mental and emotional bruising too. And the trauma of your experience would have long-lasting effects even after the bruises on your body had healed. You might become paranoid about why you were punched, fearful about it happening again. You might be angry at the person who attacked you. You might even be angry at yourself for not having been able to prevent or withstand the attack. You might feel a whole host of emotions that linger long after the event and which actually change your personality. Now, various forms of counseling can often help us when we've been hurt on an emotional level like that. And in many cases, that is enough and it works. But where hurt is very deep, there could be damage to us, not just on the physical, the mental, or the emotional level, but also on the spiritual level. And in the same way that no amount of talking to a therapist will fix a broken leg, neither is counseling alone enough to fix damage done to our broken spirits. The reason for this is because the spiritual wounds that we suffer can become infected, not by physical bacteria, but, let's stick with the analogy, by spiritual bacteria. And I make no bones about it, nor apologize for it, when I say plainly that I am referring to the darker spiritual elements of creation, or in other words, demonic activity. Such invisible beings feed off our brokenness. They look for the cuts and bruises that have scarred our spirits, and they get inside them and they start to breed. Now, if this were a physical ailment, then you would begin to see signs that something was wrong. Notably, in the case of the coronavirus, you would have difficulty breathing. That should hopefully be enough for you to seek medical attention because you would recognize the danger. But sadly, when it comes to spiritual danger, we can often be very slow to spot the signs, even though they are many and varied. For example, when we cannot forgive somebody, when we're always angry without justification, when our moods are foul and aggressive for no particular reason, when our only concern is for ourselves and we have absolutely no interest in the concerns of others, when we become spiteful, intolerant, divisive, when we hate ourselves or wish harm on others. Things like these are a clear indication that our spirit has been infected. And no amount of therapy or medication can change that. A spiritual problem can only be remedied by a spiritual solution. Only the power of the living God can bring healing to our spirits. And this, I'm pleased to say, is a duty which has been entrusted by God to his church. We have been given power and authority to cast out demons and to bind up the brokenhearted. Now, if you feel that I am talking to you today and that your own spirit has been damaged or broken, then reach out to the church for prayer and spiritual healing, and let God free you and heal you from whatever is holding you down. And now, unto God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, be ascribed as is most justly due, all might, majesty, dominion, glory, and honor, now and forevermore. Amen.
Let us pray. God the Father, your will for all people is health and salvation.
We praise and bless you, Lord.
God the Son, you came that we might have life and might have it more abundantly.
We praise and bless you, Lord.
God the Holy Spirit, you make our bodies the temple of your presence.
We praise and bless you, Lord.
Holy Trinity, one God, in you we live and move and have our being.
We praise and bless you, Lord.
Lord, grant your healing grace to all who are sick, injured, or disabled, that they may be made whole.
Hear us, Lord of life.
Grant to all who are lonely, anxious, or depressed, a knowledge of your will and an awareness of your presence.
Hear us, Lord of life.
Grant to all who minister to those who are suffering, wisdom and skill, sympathy and patience.
Hear us, Lord of life.
Mend broken relationships and restore to those in distress soundness of mind and serenity of spirit.
Hear us, Lord of life.
Sustain and support those who seek your guidance, and lift up all who are brought low by the trials of this life.
Hear us, Lord of life.
Grant peace and a holy death to those who are dying, and uphold by the grace and consolation of your Holy Spirit those who are bereaved.
Hear us, Lord of life.
Restore to wholeness whatever is broken by human sin, in our lives, in our nation, and in the world.
Hear us, Lord of life.
You are the Lord. You perform mighty wonders. You have declared your power among the peoples. With you, Lord, is the well of life, and in your light do we see light.
Hear us, Lord of life. Heal us and make us whole.
Let us be silent before God. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
The gospel calls us to turn away from sin and be faithful to Christ. As we offer ourselves to him in penitence and faith, we renew our confidence and trust in his mercy. Cast your burden upon the Lord, and he will sustain you. In returning and rest, you shall be saved. In quietness and trust shall be your strength. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. God, the Father of mercies, has reconciled the world to himself through the death and resurrection of his Son, Jesus Christ, not holding our sins against us, but sending his Holy Spirit to shed abroad his love among us. By the ministry of reconciliation entrusted by Christ to his church, receive his pardon and peace, to stand before him in his strength alone, this day and forevermore. Amen.
Hear the prayer which we offer for all your people. Remember in your mercy those for whom we pray. Heal the sick, raise the fallen, strengthen the faint-hearted, and enfold in your love the fearful and those who have no hope. In the fullness of time, complete your gracious work. Reconcile all things in Christ and make them new. Restore in us your image. Renew in us your love, that we may serve you as sons and daughters in your kingdom, through your anointed Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit we lift our voices of thanks and praise.
Blessed be God, our strength and salvation, now and forever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus said, "Your faith has made you well." May Christ bring you wholeness of body, mind, and spirit, deliver you from every evil, and give you his peace.
Amen. Amen.
The Almighty Lord, who is a strong tower for all who put their trust in him, whom all things in heaven, on earth and under the earth obey, be now and evermore your defense. May you believe and trust that the only name under heaven given for health and salvation is the name of our Lord, Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Father, almighty and ever-living God, at all times and in all places it is right to give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, according to whose promise the Holy Spirit came to dwell in us, making us your children, and giving us power to proclaim the gospel throughout the world. And so with all your people, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, Father, the creator and sustainer of all things. You made us in your own image. male and female, you created us. Even when we turned away from you, you never ceased to care for us. But in your love and mercy, you freed us from the slavery of sin, giving your only begotten Son to become man and suffer on the cross to redeem us. He made there the one complete and all-sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. He instituted, and in his holy gospel commanded us to continue, a perpetual memory of his precious death until he comes again. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks to you, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we do as Christ your Son commanded. We remember his passion and death. We celebrate his resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, grant by the power of the life-giving Spirit that we may be made one in your holy church and partakers of the body and blood of your Son, that he may dwell in us and we in him. Through the same Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ.
We, being many, are one body, for we all share in the one bread.
Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Remember that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving.
Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen.